Welcome to this year's Panto, Frozen. Enjoy the show. Once upon a time, there were two girls who lived in a place called Hackney in London. But one by one, they disappeared. In fact, eventually, their whole street disappeared, and they entered into a mysterious and wonderful underworld. Yes, they ended up at a door. They did not know if the door could open. They did not know if they would ever return home. This is a story you're about to find out the answer to those questions.
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small. And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break the rule. No right, no wrong, no rules for me.
The closed door. Eliza, Eliza, we haven't got a key.
I know, I've looked everywhere, said Eliza.
But how can we get in? I think we need to get in here. Will anyone help us? And just at that moment, two fairies appeared in the lamps, which were either side of the closed door.
Would you like help? Would you like help? They shouted.
Oh, yes, please, said Alexis.
Yes, please, said Eliza. We'd like to go inside.
Then just close your eyes and make a wish
And it will be so, said the fairies. So they closed their eyes, they made a wish, and whew, the doors opened and they entered the room. The girls slowly but surely walked the long, spooky corridor.
When the night,
Liza said, Big sister, I'm feeling a little bit scared. Don't worry, said Big Sister, I'll sing you a song.
No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me.
Meanwhile, in the main ballroom, two young girls were sitting in front of the pyre. One was called Elsa, and the other Anna. You may have seen them before. Elsa, said Anna. Yes, sister. You know, we've done such a good job of tidying this room. Santa will be so pleased. We've got mince pies out for him and a glass of sherry and a carrot for Rudolph. I think it's all spick and span, don't you? But look, said Elsa. Look at the time. It's nearly 12 o'clock. We better go to bed now. We better go to bed before Santa Claus comes. And so the two sisters went to bed. But who should appear in their place but two other sisters? You may know them as well. They're called Eliza. Big round of applause for them. Oh, we magically appeared in this beautiful room, said Eliza. Oh, look, big sister, there's a fireplace over there. Isn't it beautiful? Oh, but I think, oh, maybe, sister, we should go to sleep now. Yes, said Alexis. Let's cuddle in and have a good sleep. Oh, it's so nice in here, said Eliza. And it's so nice to be with you, little sister. Oh, you're so lovely. Thank you. Thank you. What on earth is that? Oh, said Eliza. It's a witch. It's a wicked witch. Help me, sister. Help me. Don't worry. Don't worry. If we stick together, we'll be okay.
What are you two doing here? What are you doing sitting in that chair? You're supposed to be in bed, you children. It's nearly 12 o'clock and Santa is coming. Now, get this room tidied up for Santa Claus now.
Oh, said Eliza. Oh, But the room is tidy. Look, it's spick and span.
Don't be ridiculous. There's rubbish everywhere.
I'm afraid there isn't, said Alexis. I've had a good look around and I'm a tidy girl and I can assure you that this room is spotlessly clean.
Don't be silly. What about all that rubbish over there? And there. And there.
Oh. We never saw that rubbish. Oh dear. And what should we do?
Well, you better get it cleared up before Santa Claus comes. And be quick about it. I'll be back soon to check on you. Ha ha ha.
So the two girls set about cleaning up all the rubbish, picked up all the leaves off the floor. And they even got the tiniest speck of dirt. They investigated closely.
In fact, I think Alexis used her microscope at times, and the place was spotlessly clean. So they got the rubbish and they piled it all up in the corner of the room. Well, that should be okay. I think we've made a really good job of that, said Alexis. I think so too, said Eliza.
Now I'm back. Have you cleaned up? I said it's ready for Santa Claus. What's that? What's that over there?
What?
Oh, that big pile of rubbish. What have you been doing? Go get rid of it now before Santa Claus comes.
I know, said Eliza. I can put it under the carpet.
Don't be silly, girl.
Okay, we'll hide it under the chairs.
No way, no way. Leave it to me. I'll sort it out. I'll make a magic spell and whisk it away. Abracadabra. Billy Begong. Make all that rubbish be gone.
And the wicked witch sent all the rubbish right up the chimney, much to Eliza's amazement.
Now you two, make yourselves scarce. Disappear before Santa comes, okay?
Alexis and Eliza just stared where the witch had been. She's disappeared, said Alexis. I know, said Eliza. That's what witches do. They come and they go. Oh, at least we're here, okay? Oh, I'm feeling a bit odd. I'm feeling a bit strange. I feel I'm disappearing. And with that, the girls had gone. Because it was Christmas, and who comes at midnight? That's right, Father Christmas comes. Look out for him. It's Santa Claus! Ho, 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 ho. Hello, everybody. It's Santa here. Just come to deliver the presents to the big castle. Ho, 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 ho. Oh, I can't wait. I've got lots to do. Very, very busy. Can't wait, can't wait. I'll just hop out my sled. Oh, that's better. Oh, no, better not just yet. Come in the middle of the sky. Oh, there's a roof, the castle. I'll just go down by that chimney pot. Here I come. Oh, safe landing. Well done, Rudolph. Thank you very much, reindeer. Now I'll hop out, I think. Be safe now. There I am by the chimney. So, just hop down out of the old chimney, get rid of all these presents for these children, and then I'll pop back up again, get back on my sleigh, and be on my way. Okay, only be a jiffy. Oh dear, I'm stuck in the chimney. There's something up the chimney, but the people are supposed to clean their chimneys before I come. It's full of stuff and leaves and stuff and bottles and stuff. Oh, I don't know what to do. Oh, I know what I'll do. I'll scratch my head. No, that didn't help. No, I don't know what to do. I wish someone was here to help me. And with that, he heard a voice from below, down in the house in the castle.
Hello? Hello, is that Santa you stuck in the chimney? Oh, I can help you if you like.
Oh, could you, darling? Could you really?
Yes.
Who are you?
I'm just a little old lady who lives in the castle, and I'm very nice. I'm lovely, really.
what do you suggest I do?
Well, how about you pop out the chimney? Get back out of it again. Drop the presents down the chimney. I'll collect the presents and then they'll have cleared away and then you can come down the chimney.
Oh, okay then. I'll try that right now, shall I? Okay, presents on their way.
Silly Santa Claus, I've tricked him. I'll get those presents and I'll take them away just from me. Those children won't have anything.
That's exactly what Santa did. He dropped the presents down the chimney pot, down the chimney itself, and let go, and they landed in the room.
Silly me sam, silly me gesants, I'm going to take all those presents.
And that's exactly what she did. And she disappeared, leaving behind a big sooty stain. She was a wicked witch. Santa was a bit stuck. What he did, he pulled himself up again and tried to come down feet first instead of hand first. He thought that might well solve the problem. But unfortunately it didn't. No, he was well and truly stuck. Oh, Santa, Santa, Santa. Santa said, "Help me, help me, I am stuck." Anybody there? Anyone there? Oh, I am stuck. Oi, I'm blooming stuck. Oh, this is terrible. I'm going to be here forever and no one's going to get any presents. Oh, no, 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 no. Until suddenly a little dog arrived. Woof, 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 woof. What's that noise? What's that noise? It's a dog. I can hear it. I can hear a dog as well. People started to arrive. First came Alexis. Oh! And then Eliza dropped in. Anna and Elsa arrived. And this time, Kristoff and Sven flew in on their reindeer. Wow, that was amazing. So all the gang was here. Oh no, it was somebody missing. Who can it be? Who's missing? Of course, it's good old Olaf. We're all here to help you, Santa. Oh, good. Oh, I'm so pleased, said Santa. I'm so pleased. Now, what can we do? What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? What can, woof, woof, what can we do? How about pulling and tugging? Could you do that for me? Okay, shall we all do it together? Said Alexis. Yes, okay, okay. Woof, woof. And they all started tugging. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, one last go. And there was Santa. Suddenly he was out of the chimney. Oh, well, oh, 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 thank you ever so much. Oh, you saved Christmas. I'd have been stuck there all day and nobody would have had any presents, you know. Oh, 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 look, I nearly lost a teddy at the top of my sack. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, I've never known anything like it. In all my years of delivering presents, I've never known anything quite like this. Oh, well. Well, what happened? What happened? What happened? Everybody asked. And Santa said, there was a load of blooming old rubbish stuck up the chimney. Load of rubbish. Blooming old rubbish up the chimney. Oh, I've never known the like. I've never known anything quite like it. Alexis and Eliza looked at each other and said, oh no, oh no. That was our fault. We were helping a little old lady to tidy up. That's all. We didn't mean any harm, Santa. A little old lady? Do you know, I bet it's the same one who went off with your blooming presents. She can't have got far, though. Let's search the room. And so, they all split up and searched the big room. The dog looked in the fireplace for the witch. Alexis looked round the chairs for the witch. Eliza dropped in again and looked under the carpet. Elsa and Anna looked round all the corners and all the far reaches of the room, while Kristoff and Sven searched all the walls and on top of the doorway. And that was everybody searching. Oh no, oh no, oh no, here comes Olaf. Olaf looked through all the books in the bookcase in case the witch was hiding in there, but she was not to be seen. She couldn't be seen anywhere at all. She totally and utterly disappeared. Until suddenly and spookily her face appeared on one of the pictures.
I've got all the presents. I've got all the presents. It's no good trying to catch me. I have all the presents and I've ruined Christmas, not just for you, but for every child in the world.
Eliza looked up and said, "There's no need to be nasty, you know." "Absolutely right," said Alexis. "There's no need to be nasty. It's not nice that you've ruined everybody's Christmas."
"It's what I do. I'm a wicked witch."
"Well, you don't have to be a wicked witch," said Alexis. "No, you don't," said Eliza. "No, you don't," said Olaf. "In fact, I'm going to move away from this fire soon because I'm going to melt." "Woof, woof, 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 woof."
"What's that noise?"
"It's a dog," said Alexis.
"Woof, woof, 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 woof." "Well, stop it, just stop, get it to stop making that noise. I don't like it."
"It'll stop making that noise if you give us our presents back," said Alexis.
"Yes, give our presents back," said Eliza. "And can we have them now, please? Because we need them now. And could you not be a naughty witch? I think there's so many naughty witches in the world that you should be a nice witch and be kind and gentle. And then we'd all be happy."
"I can't help it. I can't help it," said the witch.
It's because I've been stereotyped in too many pantos. There has to be a baddie."
"Well, there doesn't have to be one in our story," said Eliza. "No, there doesn't," said Alexis.
"What, you mean I can be a goody-goody?"
"Of course you can," said Anna. "You can be as good as you want to be, and we can all be happy, and we can all have Christmas dinner together."
"Do you think so? Do you think we can have a happy ending to the banto?"
said the witch. "Of course," said everybody.
"Woof, woof, of course," said the dog.
And so they had a great time. They had a party, and even Santa came to the party, and they all sang a song. Father Christmas, Father Christmas, he got stuck, coming down the chimney, coming down the chimney. What bad luck, what bad luck. All together now. Father Christmas, Father Christmas, he got stuck, coming down the chimney, coming down the chimney. What bad luck, what bad luck. Well, that's the end of this year's Panto, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Frozen 3, Saving Santa, a granddad promotion. Hope you've had a lovely Christmas and you're looking forward to next year. Bye now. Bye bye.
Oh, but could we have just one more song? Said Elsa.
Oh, well, I don't know. Do you think we've got time, children?
So, do you think we've got time for one more song?
Yes, of course we do. Okay, are you ready?
I'm forever blowing bubbles, pretty bubbles in the air. They fly so high, nearly touch the sky. And like my dreams, they fade and die. Fortune's always running. I've looked everywhere. I'm forever blowing bubbles, pretty bubbles in the air.
Well, that's the end, said Alexis.
And that's the end,
said Eliza.
Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.
Or is it the end? It is now. Bye.